r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. What's the weirdest thing you've ever had to do naked? NSFW. I broke my femur a while back and was on morphine for the pain. Morphine has a tendency to make you very constipated. Because of the leg break and surgery, I had lost a lot of blood, so every time I sat up there was a good chance of me passing out. After 6 days of not pooping, 5 nurses came into my room. I was like, "Hi, what's going on?" And they told me that they were here to help me go to the bathroom. So one of the nurses hands me a pill. You would think that the pill would take some time to get through your system, but as soon as I swallowed, my tummy made a noise like Chewbacca. It was then that 5 nurses held me upright as I sat naked taking a 6-day dump in front of them. Oh god, the morphine shit. I shat out something the size and shape of a morning star after my jaw reconstruction. Fortunately, I got to do so in private. I was in a car wreck where my mouth was also wired shut. I was in the hospital for 7 days hooked up to a morphine drip, and on day 2 or 3 of being home, I realized I hadn't shit in over a week. I expected the worst. Perhaps something like your morning star. But my first dump was no different than if I had taken my morning testimonial the previous day. Crisis averted. Back when they still had the draft, yes. I'm old. Every male had to show up at the draft office for a physical exam along with 40 or 50 other guys. Part of the exam involved standing naked in a line of guys, bending over while reaching back to spread your butt cheeks. A doctor then came down the line looking for God knows what. I clearly remember thinking every instinct tells me I shouldn't be doing this. Nobody made eye contact for a while after that. For your information, they still do this when you go into the military. Well, that settles it. No military for me. Not me, but my mom. Giving birth to my little sister. Baby's head is stuck. The nurse tells her to get on all fours in the bed. She does. Then they roll her to the surgery room down the hallways of the hospital naked. On all fours. With her head hanging out her twat. People were staring. Posed for art school. One time in university, I said I could do that. For money. But I forgot about it. Since it was in a random conversation. A month later, a guy starts calling me if I had time to do some modeling. Turns out a friend posted my number in the arts department and the caller was their coordinator or manager or something. So after a month of trying to find a time slot for me, the art class lectures and mine didn't fit. Or so. So he kept calling me twice a week. If I had time. Annoying. The first painting to be done was supposed to be high class or something. The most demanding of the students and the models. Turned out there was another guy too. And we had to do a wrestling pose. Naked. In addition to being naked for the first time in front of 8 people. I had to be in a really straining position with my arms around another dude. Sweaty. This could be the worst time for one of those random boners. Or quite possibly the best. When I was in college, I met a girl and she came over to my dorm room for some sexy times while my roommate was away for the weekend. Afterwards, we fell asleep naked in my loft bed. If you are not familiar with loft beds in college dorms, they are like beds on stilts with just enough room between you and the ceiling to sleep comfortably. I woke up to her hitting me saying, "I don't feel good. I'm gonna puke." I didn't want her puking all over my bed, so I quickly sat up. Hitting my head on the ceiling and proceeded to jump from my loft to the floor with my balls swinging like mad. I looked around and grabbed the first thing I could find for her to puke in. My garbage can. I held it above my head just as she leaned over the side of the bed to projectile vomit. Only problem was that the garbage can was made of wire mesh and I didn't have a bag in it. So there I stood holding a garbage can over my head. Completely naked. Covered in vomit. As my roommate walks in. Home early for the weekend. That girl is now my wife. And that, kids, is how I met your mother. Waited 5 hours for a locksmith. The clever naked man breaks a window and waits 5 hours inside the house for a glazier. Since having to memorize the word glazier for my 5th grade vocabulary tests, this is literally the first time I've seen it used in a non-contrived sentence. In the Air Force, we were told to strip during a field exercise. Then we headed out to an obstacle course which, due to heavy rain, had become a muddy hellhole. We were told to pick up large logs and we had to run them through the obstacle course. Double time. naked, in the rain. I've never before nor ever after seen muddy dongs bounce up and down in perfect unison, nor do I ever wish to do so again. Anyways, after the run we went straight for our gear. Seeing as it was ducking cold. A fraction of a second before I can grab my stuff, the Sarge comes running like a bat out of hell. Screaming to get into formation. We do. Standing abso-ducking-lutely naked on a muddy field with 49 other dudes. Stiff as a pole. For near half an hour. I never really understood the point of that exercise. Ninja edit. I just realized my horrible wording and feel a need to specify. Not an erection in sight. Bet if you checked your commanding officer you might have found that elusive erection. The military does some surprisingly gay shit considering they have been against homosexuality until very recently. When I was a senior in high school, I played the rite of passage game of senior tag. For those who don't know, teams of typically 5 high school seniors get together on a team with super suckers and are pitted against another team for a week. The team at the end of the week with the fewest players sprayed out advances to the next round in a tournament-style recreation of immaturity. Good times. One of the rules was that you couldn't shoot or be shot out of the game while naked. You were fair game outside and I had to make it to my car to go to school. As I was prepared to leave, I looked up at our CCTV screen. Yes, I had a camera outside my garage door to see if anyone was around my car. I look at the monitor to see 2 hot girls holding super suckers crouched behind my car. I then went into my garage, disrobed, holding only a shirt in front of my stuff, opened the garage door, and went on to glory. I shot one girl completely by surprise, and then dropped my shirt, thus making me unshootable. The other, who I had no time to shoot, stood there in disbelief that their plan to get me had failed. There I stood with a super sucker, screaming a victory scream at the top of my lungs on a cold May morning. Completely naked. TLDR. I shot 2 hot girls with a super sucker while naked in my front yard. What a coincidence. I also call my penis the super sucker. I had just got out of the shower and realized that I had accidentally left the garage door open. I peek out the little bathroom window and see a guy walking out of the garage with boxes of booze we had just got for a party. I ran out to the garage buck naked, still dripping from the shower, and yelled as loud as I could. It's a busy street. Everyone looks at me. The thief freaks out and starts unloading the booze and putting it back in the garage. He pulls out 100 bucks and says, "Don't call the cops." I refuse. Call the cops and put some pants on. TLDR. Buck naked man foils robbery. Edit. Butt to buck. Again. Nobody ducks with naked dude. It sends a pretty clear message that if you'll waste no time ducking with pants, you mean business. Good to know. If I ever need to foil the robbery, I'll strip first. Made bacon. Never again. My husband has a big scar on his chest. When he was 12. He was frying egg rolls with no shirt on. He sloshed hot oil on himself. His skin bubbled up and hurt for a bit. Then turned black and he couldn't really feel it anymore. So he went back to playing Nintendo. His dad got home and freaked the duck out and rushed him to the hospital. He now tells people his scars are from fighting tigers as a child prince in Asia. That's ducking badass. Similar story to the OP. Kinda. Was having sex with an ex-girlfriend. We were on bad terms but we both considered each other as grade A ducks, so we'd boot a call one another when life got stressful. We were both single at the time, so it was a mutual deal. She recently adopted a kitten. So we're going at it for a good long while when I feel the kitten jump onto the bed and climb up on my back. I have a fairly long ponytail. And the kitten, presumably hypnotized by its bouncing motion, dove upon it and clung on. Nom-noming at its base. Now. Understand we're both coming up on home stretch. Not the time you want to stop. X hasn't noticed. And it's not hurting me. So I keep right on going. I'm racing to the finish. But it's getting to me. I stifle a giggle. Then another. This perturbs my ex. Who says what? What? I can't entirely blame her for being pissy. Having a lover giggling like a schoolgirl as you're nearing orgasm isn't very helpful. But I'm about to go. and I don't want to ruin it for myself. So I'm not about to explain it. Instead, I swing my head to the side and cause the kitten to perform an Indiana Jones maneuver, effectively striking my ex in the face with a kitten as I climax. Worth it. So, wait, you smacked the girl you were banging in the face with her own kitten. Now that's skill. When I was 21, I went to go visit my sister and her husband in Utah. They were Mormon at the time, but they had recently become friends with some swingers and naturalists, read, nudists. They invited me to go to someone's house for a hot tub party, and they warned me ahead of time that people there would be nude. They also told me most of the people there were Mormon naturalists. Yes. This apparently exists. Anyway. I got there and everyone was naked. But just sitting around doing normal party stuff. Watching a movie, playing cards, but no drinking. They are Mormon. After all. So. I strip down. Wrap a towel around myself and head to the hot tub. I had been to a few nude beaches the previous summer and swam nude. So I was no rook. But this situation was still a little awkward. After the hot tub, I'm hanging indoors. Still naked. And here is where things got strange. Everyone decides we are going to play a game. I instantly become worried I'm going to get wrapped up in some strange sex thing. Especially being a young female. But no. We played some kind of mystery game where someone is the detective and someone is the criminal and you have to guess who it is. It was a game I remembered playing at some church activity when I was a teenager and still Mormon. Definitely the strangest thing I have ever done naked. Edit. Naturist. Not naturalist. Colon. I believe you're talking about Mafia. Specifically Naked Mormon Mafia. My favorite version. Whenever my girlfriend is mad, I do a striptease then get naked and do the helicopter to the milkshake song by Keyless. Is the helicopter what I think it is? Oh yes. I was living alone in a one-bedroom apartment in a high-rise building. I was in the shower. And I heard someone in my apartment. Now. I know I'll lock the door. So without even thinking. My 6'3". 200-pound frame went bounding out of the bathroom to see the two building maintenance guys staring at me in complete shock. Maintenance guy number one blurts out. There might be a leak. Me. Adrenaline still flowing and still very naked yell, well is there? And they both ran out. Never to be spoke of again. Maybe more awkward than weird. When I had sex for the first time, it was because my girlfriend casually asked, do you have a condom? This caught me off guard, but I was prepared with a condom in my wallet. Then it hit me. My wallet was in my jacket. Two stories below. I jumped out of bed naked. Past my brother's room who had friends over. And to the ground floor where my parents had visitors. I found the condom and ran upstairs. And when I arrived back, completely flaccid, it was go time. I have the vision that your bed was immediately next to a direct drop to the ground floor. You jump out of bed in a skydive pose. Completely naked. You fly through the air. The wind unable to bend your eager manhood. You hurtle past the window of your brother's room and land silently on the ground floor. Nobody notices. Grabbing the Johnny, you head back upstairs to complete the mission. In my mind's eye, I see a big, pink, flaccid flying squirrel. Posted this a while back, here you go. I had just moved to Japan when a friend of mine invited me to a little party for a friend of his visiting town. On the way there, he informed me that his friend is famous in Japan. A member of a not-to-be-named J-pop band. I had no idea who he was. And he was a nice enough guy. But when we went to the club district in our town, every girl on the street was jaw-dropping at the sight of him, and my friend was covering the guy's face saying, he's not here. You didn't see him. We'd go to a snack bar. Or in other words, an expensive place to drink where prostitutes serve you drinks. And my friend gets a call that a member of the local Yakuza family wanted to come hang out. And the guy shows up, and within 10 minutes he decides we're moving the party to another snack bar. He settles the tab for all of us, 20 people or so, and we go to this smaller, more intimate snack bar to drink and sing karaoke. The Yakuza guy's assistant gets up to sing a song. And before I know it, he's stripped down naked and everyone thinks it's hilarious. In my infinite wisdom, I pulled a 100 yen coin, a buck, from my pocket and handed it to the guy as a joke. The Yakuza guy starts busting up laughing and I'm thinking, good job. How's that for irony? You made a friend in Japanese organized crime. A few songs later it's my turn to sing. And the formerly naked guy comes to me and hands me a 500 yen coin, and that's when I realized the bar had been raised. I'm freaking out and figured I'd better at least take my shirt off to appease the crowd. No sooner was my shirt off when people, mostly guys, mind you, started going for my belt and removing my jeans and briefs, and suddenly I'm naked singing Smells Like Teen Spirit in front of a Japanese kingpin and an idol. The song ended and I was quickly back in my clothes and the rest of the evening was uneventful. I'm just glad it wasn't too cold in there so my little guy didn't get stage fright. TLDR. I sang karaoke naked in front of a Japanese mafia guy and a Japanese pop star. P. I had a, sort of, similar experience when visiting Japan for a scientific conference. Our host takes us out to a very fancy izakaya. A sort of pub restaurant that's divided up into separate little rooms for groups. I tell our host how nice this place is. And he replies, yes. The Yakuza-owned places are always best. I'm not entirely sure if he's joking or not. I just kinda look at him incredulously, but apparently I look terrified and he reassures me by telling me, don't worry. Yakuza would never hurt a white man. The rest of the evening I feel a curious combination of fear and invincibility. I sleep naked. And one night I was in bed and hearing a bunch of local college kids making a bunch of noise outside. Hence, I could not fall asleep with all the noise they were making. I get out of bed and walk outside in the buff and yell, naked dude needs to sleep. So shut the duck up. Totally worked. Nobody ducks with naked dude. Nobody ducks with naked dude. Actually, most people do. Naked dude here. I can confirm this. Changed an exterior light bulb in the snow. I was at a friend's birthday party a couple of years ago and we had a splendid idea of turning his bathroom into a sauna. So, we got in an electric heater, turned it on full, and shorted out the extractor fan. The bathroom didn't have windows. Also, in our infinite wisdom, instead of putting water on the heater, we decided to use vodka, watered down a tad so it didn't catch fire, so we could get nice and drunk off the fumes as well. Anyway, once it was nice and warm and there was two bottles of vodka floating in the air, we all decided we should try it out. There were seven of us, so we could more or less fit in. We decided to do it properly, so went in more or less naked, with towels around our waists. The experience was mind-blowing. Almost impossible to describe. Sort of swimming in a sticky dark drunkenness. Getting more and more intoxicated with every breath. After about 10 seconds, two guys ran out and ended up racing each other to the sink. Another guy just said duck it and walked out shortly after. The rest of us didn't stay in there much longer. And another three guys, me included, ended up chundering. Had to Google what chundering was. Crazy Australians and their vomit synonyms. I thank you for being brave. All my internet experience was telling me that I shouldn't Google that. But you took one for the team. We have an outdoor shower at my aunt's lake house. Basically, the shower head sticks out of the side of the trailer. And she has tarps tied to the tree nearby that act as sides to the shower. I decided once this might be fun to try to shower in. Suddenly, massive winds started blowing the tarps around and showing my nakedness to everyone around the lake. So I mac-jivered the tarps as fast as I could by tying bricks to the bottom. The winds got even stronger. So I was showering whilst bricks were being parachuted onto my toes. Overall, not a magical experience. Edited for grammar. So the weirdest thing you had to do while naked was shower. You dirty bastard. I love the assessment at the end. This shower did not provide the expected level of enjoyment. F. Would not wash again. In a bar in Portugal, one of my friends started chanting naked bar over and over. So we all got naked and just proceeded as if it was normal. Ordering drinks, talking to women, taking a piss, everything. Then the manager came down. He told us we had to keep the noise down. He didn't mind the nudity. But if the police came, they would probably not see the funny side. There were about 20 of us. Also, ordering a pint nude. In a bar, it is pretty fun watching the confused barmaid look down, then readjust her gaze and sit in shocked silence confusion for a few seconds before serving you. To this day, I'm still amazed they didn't care more. I broke up, sort of. We were never quite official, with a girl on the phone while wearing nothing but a strap-on and a party hat. Edit. The party hat wasn't of the cone variety, but of the small top hat variety. Edit 2. Yes. I have a taco down there. Here's the thing with this. You wanna know the thing with this? Here's the thing. This woman wasn't wearing a strap-on for the hell of it. No. She was with somebody. And mid-duck. She's like. Shit. Hold on. I have to call my girlfriend and dump her sorry ass. Then I'll keep thrusting. That's not the thing yet. Though. The thing is. When they were done. They left the Chuck E. Cheese bathroom and returned to a kid's birthday. Party hat. Instantly RuneScape. I went into a doctor's office to ask about an abnormal lump in my testicular sac, which turned out not to be cancer. Thank God, and he asked me to remove my pants and underwear. He took a look and then asked for another doctor at the same office to come take a look. Then, for a third opinion, the doctor asked for a couple of nurses to come in and look. Four pairs of inquisitive eyes looking over my goods for 30 minutes. I was extremely pissed. So, when the second doctor and two nurses, one of which was very cute, left, I waited until the doctor was looking very closely at my ballsack again and I ran my fingers through his hair and said, "Oh doctor, I can't tell you how I've dreamt of this moment." The doctor stood up, looked me in the eye and with a smirk on his face said, "You aren't the first to say that line to me. Guess other people watched Andrew Dice Clay when they were a kid too." I went to the doctors with testicular pain, so four doctors groped my balls later, three of which were female. I am sent to get an ultrasound to be sure. So in walks an extremely attractive nurse who proceeds to tell me to drop my pants. She covered the machine with lubrication and proceeded to rub my balls with it for 10 minutes. Reaching about grabbing my penis to adjust me. Great memory. Only way I kept control was thinking cancer, cancer, cancer. Good thing you did. They know a trick called inflicting pain on your penis to make it go away. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.